If you love customizing Windows, then you're going to like this video. Today, we'll explore some of the best small tweaks that can completely change the way you use your PC. Without wasting any time, let's get started. First up, we have Fluent Flyout, a sleek modern audio flyout that blends beautifully with Windows. It replaces the default audio flyout with a more polished and modern look, using Microsoft's Fluent 2 design principles. It listens to both your volume and media inputs, showing details about the song, title, artist, and album cover when you're adjusting media settings. In the settings, you can enable the compact layout. It hides the repeat and shuffle button. You can also change the duration the flyout stays on the screen. There's a seek bar option as well, which I think is a good option. Another nice feature that it has is this option. It shows you the next song's info when a song or video ends, so you'll get notified about what's going to play next. Another great feature of this tweak is the key flyout. So when you enable it, it shows an on-screen notification when you enable these keys, caps lock or scroll lock. It's a pretty nice looking flyout, you can use it now, link in the description. This tweak offers smooth animations, integrates with both light and dark modes, and uses Windows Mica blur effect, making it feel completely natural on Windows 11. You can customize its position on your screen. Windows doesn't offer animations on context menu, so if you like smooth animations like me, you can try Breeze Shell. It's an alternative context menu for Windows 10 and 11 that brings fluency and elegance back to your desktop. To install it, head over to the page linked in the description, download the Windows build zip, extract it, and launch this application. Then when you get here, enable inject all and start on boot, so it runs automatically. Finally, restart Explorer. If it didn't work for you, make sure you don't have any other customization on your context menu. Now when you right click an item on your desktop or file explorer, you'll notice smooth animations on the context menu. You can control everything from item height to background radius and even extend its functionality using JavaScript if you're into coding. Breeze is lightweight and fast, perfect if you want both performance and style. Next up is BeWidgets, a simple way to make your desktop look and feel more personal with fully customizable widgets. It lets you add widgets for things like time, date, weather, financial info which didn't work for me, app shortcuts, and photos. So when you launch the app, there are three icons. First, we need to create a widget. You can start by setting a name, then selecting the widget type. Here you can also customize almost anything: position, width, height, font size, clickability, movability, and if it's 24-hour format or not. You can also change the background color, and for weather you can set your city. If it's incorrect, you can adjust it. The finance section didn't work for me due to an internet issue, I think, but you can test it. It's a good option for tracking cryptocurrency prices. You can create as many widgets as you need and arrange them however you want for a truly personalized experience. BeWidgets gets new updates every week to keep things fresh. So whether you're looking for a minimalistic setup or want to fill your desktop with useful information, BeWidget is fast, optimized, and ready to go. Speaking of clock, you can also customize your taskbar clock using ElevenClock. Let's take a look at it. Microsoft's default clock is pretty basic, but with ElevenClock you can customize it any way you like. You can tweak everything from the time format, such as adding seconds or the day of the week, the clock styler, color, and position. There are also some themes here you can choose from. I think this one looks nice. It lets you customize what happens when you click or double click on the clock. The only issue I encountered with ElevenClock was the taskbar's auto hide feature. When the taskbar hides, the clock didn't hide. I don't know why was that. If you don't use auto hide taskbar, this is a good option. If you use a hidden taskbar, you can customize your clock using Windhawk, another Windows customization app. Windhawk has fewer customization options than ElevenClock, but it works fine. Feel free to customize it according to your needs. The best part is ElevenClock's support of multiple monitors. You can have clocks on all displays or just the ones you want. Finally, let's talk about YASB Reborn, powerful status bar tool that allows you to do almost anything on your desktop. It's a great tool if you enjoy using a customizable status bar. To install it, head over to the release section on their GitHub page. I leave the link below. Before installing YASB Reborn, make sure you install this font on your system. If you don't, this will not work properly. It shows you a square instead of icons. You can also change themes. There are a lot of themes you can choose from. Just right click on tray icon and click on the Get Themes. Here you can choose any you like. I like the Windows 11 theme. Just click on install and done. On their GitHub page, there is a list of 34 available widgets you can add to your status bar. These widgets provide useful functions like application shortcuts, CPU monitoring, clock integration, OBS studio controls, internet traffic monitoring, weather, Wi-Fi, and the power menu. If you don't like your current theme widget, you can change them to anything you like. To add any of these widgets, you need to edit the config file. To access it, click on the tray icon, right click on the YASB icon, and select Open Config. Here you can edit it using a code editor or text editor. If you're unsure how to do this, simply ask ChatGPT. You just need to select the widget you want and it will show you an example. You need to put this example with your options that you want and your code. And that's a wrap. Hope these tweaks give your Windows a brand new vibe. If you tried any of these, let me know in the comments. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more ways to take your tech game to the next level. Catch you in the next one.